This morning, we are going to begin our message by watching a video clip. Pay attention, please. I'm going to ask you a question.
Real close. Real close. Now back up. Back. Turn around. Back up. One more. Real close. Real close. Hold it. Real close. Get close. Get closer. Say three, you can get it, but don't you get it till I say three now, okay? One, two, four, six, 11, 25, three.
That was cool.
Now, can you go? Do that? Anybody? Who wouldn't love a dog like that? So obedient, right? PK used to be very obedient, not as much as that dog, and I didn't know how to train her, but at least I could give her commands, go shishi here, poop over there, designate areas, and I even trained her to shake hands, and she listened, and she follows, and I enjoyed having her. Lately, she disobeyed me. Perhaps because she's gotten old, and she has these medical conditions that I've been pampering her too much. And when I try to lead her, she doesn't follow my guidance. And she tried to yank me around, lead me, and I know what is in front of her, and the gate or door or wall is in front of her, and so I try to lead her to avoid so that she won't get her nose into it, and she wouldn't let me. I mean, sometimes I have to let her bang herself, you know? And when I think of that, and her attitude, her way of leading me reminds a lot of my faith journey. She used to be very faithful and very obedient. Now it's kind of mishap, and I can say she disobeyed me. And do you know what the main reason why she does that? With all those medical conditions, everything, but one thing for sure, that she knows that I love her. And no matter what, I will not ditch her. And no matter what, I will not abandon her. I will give in to her because she is suffering, she is having a hard time. She doesn't do that to my husband and to me. So she knows how to get away, get around with my feelings. And having said that, why are we on the obedient dog is because that's what we are on the study series called Walk the Talk, right? We are on the study Walk the Talk, and second lesson is what? About being good. And when I don't feel like being good, what am I supposed to do? And everybody can be real obedient to God's commandments if it fits our logic, if when we like to do, if when we are available to do, we do not mind to be obedient. We're not talking about that. When we don't feel like coming to church and worship on Sunday Sabbath, keep the Sabbath, I want to stay in bed. How do I obey keep the Sabbath? When I have difficulties in my finances, how do I keep the giving tithe faithfully? How, when I don't feel like to love someone, how do I, what will cause me to love someone? You see, when we first met Jesus, we were so, feel so appreciative what he has done. So he saved us from the bottom of the pit, and we appreciate it. We rejoice, and I'm set free and rejoice, and I'm dancing, and when I meet everybody, we talk about Jesus and salvation and etc., etc. And now, we know how much God loves us, and we know He's not going to abandon us, ditch us, because John chapter 10 verse 28, Jesus says, no one can snatch you out of his hand.
Amen.
And Romans 8:38-39, there is nothing in the whole wide world can separate us from God's love. Nor depth and light, and height and depth and width and anything, everything. Nothing can separate us from God's love.
Amen.
Therefore, we know God's going to forgive us if we fail. He's going to give us a second chance, another chance after another chance. He will love us forever. Oh, He will understand if I stay in bed. Oh, He will understand. Yes, if I go to beach and surfing, He will understand. I use my tithe to buy me a new car. He will understand. And I will do that later. Delay obedience is what?
Disobedience.
And our Bible, the lesson says, when I don't feel like being good, and how do I? And it teaches us that being good means equals integrity, keep the integrity. And being good equals being more like God. God is good
all the time.
All the time.
God
is good. So if we want to be good, what should we be doing? Whatever God commands us, we want to do. The good God asks us to do good things, that if we do it, we obey it, and then it's gonna be good people. We are going to be more like Jesus,
Amen.
More like God. We can be called being good people. So, what would be the foundation of being good when I don't feel like it? What? How can you renew your mind? So you gotta renew your mind with the truth. So that your mind can influence your heart can influence to act, right? We know this. So how do you influence your mind? With the Word of God. And let's see the foundation of why we should be obeying God's commandments when, even when we don't feel like it. Amen? I will come up with the HML. It sounded like a TV.
Hawaii
Football
League.
Huh? Yeah? H, oh, Hawaii what?
Football League.
Oh, okay, let's do that. Hawaii Football League. If it helps you to remember, right? H stands for hope. Hope in Christ in His living word.
Amen.
And then second, faith. Hope and faith. Faith in Christ. And then three is what?
Love.
Yeah, you smart cookies. So, Let's look at the first one. First one is what? Football. Hawaii. Okay, pop. Let's look at verse 3. Let's read it together, verse 3.
Praise be to God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ.
In His great mercy, He has given us new birth into a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead.
Amen. What does that mean? Praise God who gave us new birth into a living hope through what? Resurrection of Jesus Christ. And we know when we accept this salvation, we have eternal life. We have eternal hope. We have a hope in our future. And living hope is we have a hope here, down here. If we, Jesus did not offer the hope down here, living hope here, then we might as well be married, and at the end of life, then we say, okay, I accept you. Like a criminal on the cross, last minute you can accept Jesus and you go to heaven, right? But Jesus Christ, not only salvation, not only gives us a hope in the future, but hope in the present time. That living hope is in, recorded in the Word of God, and when you abide by, when you do obey the Word of God, you are going to be blessed. God's going to bless your socks off. That's when you understand the living hope, you understand abundant life here. Jesus came not only to give us eternal life, but abundant life here. Amen. While you are in the journey of sanctification, Amen. Justification happens right there when you accept Jesus Christ. And from that moment on, you are in the journey of sanctification. And for that, if you obey, then you are going to be rewarded. Mm. You see, you know, our dogs, why do they obey? Or how do you teach the tricks? You give them?
Treat.
Reward, right? And when we obey, God gives us what? Blessings. You see, my brother, when he became a new Christian, he says, I told him, you are going to experience such a tremendous blessing in your life. And he was all, you know, hope for that experiencing, that the tremendous blessing. And then he says, for a while he's been going into church and accept Jesus and this and that. And sister, I don't feel like going to church anymore. Why is that? You said there is abundant life waiting for me, but there is no abundant life. I have to give my tithe, I have to serve in the choir, there is lots of goals, so I can smoke, I can drink, I start cursing, and a lot of restrictions here. Sometimes we feel that way, right? But you keep following what God has said, Amen. And you are going to be blessed. My brother, he came in the beginning, he couldn't speak English, so he made only $600 a month because he was paid under table for Korean, you know, owners and etc. He couldn't speak English, so he couldn't get a job. Anyway, I taught him to give $60. He says, 10% is $60, right? He says it's not fair. He needs that $60 to buy him gas and this and that. But I said, if you do, God's going to bless your socks off. Because Malachi chapter 3 verse 10, and memorize it. You know? And God said, if you give me your tithe and see, test me, see if I'm not going to open the floodgate of heaven and pour out the blessings Amen. Onto you, and you're not going to have a store. It's gonna be overflow your story. And so, you sure, sister? I said, I'm sure. Look at my life. I never worry about money, you know? And then he says, okay, sister, I'm gonna do it. guess what? Now he's making much more than that, and also he became elder of his church, ruling as elder of his church, and that needs to be, you have to give a faithful tithe, you have to give attendance, you have to be participate, you have to be good, memorize Bibles, and all that he did it. Now God has blessed his socks off, he has a house of his own, and his daughters in college, etc., etc. I mean, you wouldn't believe. And also for you who have done faithfully tithing to God, you know what I'm talking about, right?
Right.
Yes.
Amen.
And God's going to bless your socks off when you obey the word of God, and because you have a living hope. What God's going to do,
Amen.
What God has promised to do. Remember Moses. Now let's go back to Moses. Moses, when he was tending the sheep, he saw what? The burning bush that wasn't consumed by fire. So curiosity killed the cat, right? And he approached the burning bush, and then voila, he encountered the presence of God, and God called him, Moses, and he says, here I am, and God says what? Go to Pharaoh and Israelites, and tell them I'm sending you to deliver Israelites out of Egypt. And go to Pharaoh's, tell him, let my people go. And then he says, how am I gonna do? I'm nobody. Who's gonna believe me? And da 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 da. And then chapter 4, it goes on and conversation goes on. And then chapter 4, God says, what do you have in your hand? He had what?
Staff.
God says what? Throw it on the ground and it turns into a snake. So he jumped back, I would, right? And then God said an unthinkable command. Pick it up by the tail. And those of you, I think Pemba Blue knows that you don't pick up the snake by the tail, right? You pick up by the tail, it's going to strike you. So you pick up. Yeah. And if you were there and God asked you to do unthinkable, unimaginable, it's a very dangerous thing, what would you have done? You know, I would have argued or run away or disappear from God, argue that, hello God, have you forgotten how you created a snake? You're the one who should know, right? Come on. Tell me to pick up by the tail, no way. But Moses didn't say a word, and he picked it up. And that's when it turns into staff again. So he used that staff to bring God's power,
Amen.
To bring blessings, to lead his people out of Egypt. And he used that to part the Red Sea and brought the flags and Nile River turned into blood and what else? I mean, struck the rock and the water, etc., etc. Hallelujah! When you obey God's command, God's going to
bless
you. Amen. You saw smart cookies this morning, and our dogs know that. And dogs do that, and better yet, when they are trained to receive reward, do certain action, and if you don't give them, they still do. Even PK still does shishi on the shishi spot, because in the beginning I had to give her treat all the time. Now she's trained, and she does it even though I don't give you a treat. Even though God doesn't give you a blessing, right? When you do good things, you still gotta do it because you are trained, obedient servant.
Amen.
Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. That's what we are better than dogs. Amen. That's what's going to motivate us. That's what we have to renew our mind with, that we have a hope. in Jesus Christ, living hope in Jesus Christ. It's written in the Word of God. Amen?
Amen.
And the second one is what?
Faith.
Okay, would you please read verse 8? Verse 8, 1, 2, 3.
Though you have not seen him, you love him. And even though you do not see him now, you believe in him and are filled with an inexpressible and glorious joy.
Amen. And then we didn't record verse 9. Verse 9 says, so if you believe him because you haven't, even though you haven't seen him, and you love him even though you haven't met him, and verse 9 says, because of you did that, and the result of your faith in Jesus Christ, in the gospel of Jesus Christ, what?
The salvation of your soul.
Salvation, you receive the salvation of your souls. So, what he said is, since you begin with your faith, accepting Jesus as your Lord and Savior, to the sanctification, still continue, walk by faith. Walk by faith. And in order for us to walk by faith, faith has action, right?
Amen.
Faith without action is what? D-E-A-D.
Dead.
Why should be faithful? Why should we have a faith in God? Because you have a big God, and the Spirit of living God will empower you, continue to have faith in him. Now, do you say our God is faithful?
Yes.
Our God is so faithful to us, and he wants us to be just like him. So if we understand, we experience God's faithfulness toward us, we shall be faithful to God. Therefore, whatever God asks us, we trust God. Then we forgot to do it. When we say we trust God, and then God says, do this, and if we don't do it, what kind of oxymoron that is? Right? When you say you trust him, and then he says something or do it, and you don't do it. And God says, I'll be with you forever. You believe, and yet sometimes you act as if God took off. Sometimes we do that, right? Our God is so faithful. He's with us in this life and life after. And we want to see another video clip for God's faithfulness. It's translated in the clip. Let's watch that, and then I will continue to talk about it.
All your time with you, blessed and shame, for break that would make it okay. Feel not good enough, and it's hard at the end of the day. I need some distraction. Oh, vultures and thieves at your back. So keep yourself twisted. Keep on building the lights that you make up for
us. Isn't it a touching moment? I mean, dogs are so faithful. And that kind of reminds us of how our God is. And even when we are alive and talking and speaking, God is still with us. Even when we are dead, meet, we do not know His presence around. We can't even recognize His presence. He's still there for us. And not only after our death, but during this life, the situations so heavy on us, we seemingly die. Things like relationship matters, or financial situations, or health issues, we feel like a dead guy in that video clip. And God is nearby us. Unlike that dog, he couldn't do much about his master. He was just hanging around. But our God is what? Powerful! Our God can raise that situation to alive. Our God can raise that from the dead to life. That faithful God is with us. How about us? Are we faithful? We say, I'm never gonna worry what tomorrow will bring. I can count on God. Mm-hmm. Can God count on you? Let's flip the image. Let's say the dog represents us, and that master is like God. When you bring your issues, when you bring your agonies, when you bring your prayers, God doesn't answer right away. And God seems to be so remote and so far away. God seems to be dead to your situation. Will you be still hanging around and asking God, hoping God to help you, lift you out of that situation? Amen. Can God trust? God put His trust on you. If we have faith to begin with, God's going to complete it in us until the day of Jesus Christ. Amen. God is working in us. And we know God is faithful to us no matter what we are going through. Therefore, it influences our hearts that we shall be faithful. We shall be obedient. God said, don't worry about what tomorrow will bring. We say, yes, God, I will not worry about what tomorrow will bring. I'm gonna, you take and give. I'm gonna rejoice, be glad in it. Jehovah Jireh. When Abraham took Isaac, God asked Abraham to sacrifice his only son, Isaac, when he had prayed. Finally, he got him. And God said, go sacrifice him. And when he was preparing to sacrifice his son, Abraham said what? God will see. God will see to it. His faith is God will provide. Not, that's why He is named as what? Faithful of all history. Do you trust God? Without faith, Hebrews 11:6, it's impossible to please God. For a smile on God's faith, we shall walk the talk. We shall be faithful, and we shall remember, even though when we don't feel like to obey, we have begun the journey with the faith we shall be faithful. Got it? And the third is what?
Love.
Thank you for being so smart this morning. All because of your worship. And illumine our hearts to ready to hear the message. And everybody's alert this morning.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
Love. John chapter 14:15. John chapter 14, verse 15, Jesus said what? If you love me, you will what? Obey my commandments. Jesus didn't say, if you keep all the commandments, then you love me. Right? Jesus said, if you love me, your love for me will produce obedience to follow the commandments.
Amen.
How many of you know you will keep and following the laws and commandments even though you don't feel like it, even though you don't love? You know what I'm talking about? You know, I would love to speed. And Mokulele Highway, and when there is no part, it says 45. I said, forget it, I'm going, right? But if I don't want to pay the consequences, then I shall obey the law. My husband is good at it. Now, he always set his speed limit. He doesn't speed. Now, does he do that because he loves police? He loves the law, traffic law? No, he doesn't want to pay the fine. Right? So we can keep the commandments and obey without love. That's what Jesus is saying, without love. But you cannot not keep the commandments if when you love me. And Jesus wants us to love him.
Amen.
More than anything else.
Mm-hmm.
You know, in our kids, those of you who have teenagers, that you know that you can make your kids to obey your rules, your commandments, right? You can threaten them. Hey, you live here. I put the food on the table, roof over your head, and this is my house. I rule this house. If you don't obey, you're going to be... I'm going to kick you out, right? And they obey you. Now, wouldn't you be very happy when your kids obey you just out of respect, out of honoring you, out of love for you, even though you know that is kind of stretch, command, but your kids do it just because they love you.
Amen.
Wouldn't you love that? Amen. That's what our Lord Jesus wants you to do.
Amen.
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 Because Jesus, we all love Jesus. We say we love Jesus because he first
loved
us.
Amen.
Now let's look at another video clip. How he loved us.
To me,
Try to love one another. Some will reject you. Some will push your buttons all the time. Some will hurt you. Some will badmouth about you. Some will try to bring all sorts of troubles to you. Will you be patiently, compassionately, step by step, even though you got rejected, you're gonna try one more time, even though he or she doesn't want your love, doesn't want to do anything with you, are you still going to, like that dog? When you do that, when you be able to do that, then you truly know how to love Jesus. If you love Jesus, you will do that continually. You will obey His commandments. Amen?
Amen.
God is good?
All the time.
All the time?
God is good.
God is good. If we will not be good people, we've got to obey good God's good commandments so that we can become good people.
Amen.
So what should we have in our mind, or how should we be transformed our thoughts? What is the foundation, necessary things that we have to think?
Hope.
Is what?
Hope, faith, and love.
Faith and love.
Amen. You are so smart. Hope and faith and love. Among, see, the 1 Corinthians chapter 13, at the end, 13, I believe, there is three remains, faith and hope and love, but what?
The greatest
is
love.
Amen?
Amen?
If you love God, yes, Lord God. And when we do that, when we have that mind influence our hearts, when we act accordingly, God going to?
Yes.
Yes.
Amen?
And you become a good, good people. Amen. Let us pray. Oh God, we give you thanks for your faithful servants are here this morning. Worship you, honor you, respect you. Oh Lord God, we want to show how much we love you. We want to show you how much you can trust us. We want to show you how much we trust, we count on you. Oh Lord God, we want to express. We want to keep. We want to be pushing forward, pressing forward. One thing in mind, the great prize waiting for us. When all is said and done, we want to hear, well done, my good and faithful servant. Oh Lord God, bless our socks off so that we can continue to grow and mature to be more like you. Yes, Lord, we love you. We bless you, Lord. We love your spirit in us, touching our hearts, illumine our hearts, and renew our spirit. Yes, Lord, restore our life. Restore our faith journey. Yes, Lord, you are powerful God. And we want to walk with you. We want to walk the talk. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Thank you for being with us this morning. Thank you for empowering us to live life worthy of your Son's sacrifice. Yes, Lord. Thank you for the lesson. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Now it's time.